Hey, Kevin. What are you doing?
Playing with a toy. This is a magnetic drill press. Great big electromagnet right here in the base. You can just push the button, and it'll suck itself right through a piece of steel. You can't pick that thing up for nothing. This is a piece of 1¼-inch thick steel. I've got to drill 6 holes through it. And if I sat out here with my poor little cordless, I'd be here for about a week trying to drill all these holes. Because to sit here and try and push on this and get it to go straight down through the steel, you wind up with a big wobble, or you wind up going off in an angle, or you wind up snapping the drill off inside the hole. That's really bad. This is so much easier. With a great big motor, with a magnetic base, and it's just like a big drill press, but you can take it wherever you need it. Come here, I'll show you something closer here. So this was my first bit. When you're drilling in really thick steel, or you're gonna make a big hole, you always start with a small bit, make a pilot hole. And then you come back with a next larger bit. You can jump a few steps. And then you come back with your next bigger bit. And then you come back with your finished bit. Nice, you know, a good progression from one size to the next. You can cut a hole quickly, but you're not taking this 1-inch diameter bit and try to shove it through 1¼-inch worth of steel. You just burn up the end of the bit, burn up the drill. So that's why you make steps as you go. So I've already cut 2 holes. So now I'll go to my next size bit. And you can tell this one's been broken off a few times and been resharpened. They were the same length at one point. The great thing with this magnetic base is now it stays perfectly aligned over the hole. So I can change my bits, I can clean up my mess as I'm going, so I'm not sitting here kneeling in metal shavings, but I know I'll come right back to the same hole again. And here we go again. As sharp as razor blades, the edges.
Where are your safety glasses, Kevin?
My safety glasses are over there, being safe, of course. Because I'm up above it, all of the chips are coming out to the sides. You know, if I was sitting on the ground with this thing right in front of my face, oh yeah, I'd be wearing a face shield, I'd be wearing gloves. You know, I should be. You're right. Okay, so now we just put the next bit in, make our last hole. Clean up the mess, move on to the next one. Thank you. I am. Using that little drill, using the little handheld drill. I was doing it with this drill. Big heavy duty, lots of torque, lots of power to it. But as the bit would start to get down into the metal, and if it bit in and the bit stopped turning, this handle comes around and it either whacks you in your shin or tries to break your wrist. Normally you would have two handles on it, one on either side. A lot of times you have two guys hanging onto it from either side and another guy just pushing, just trying to keep the bit buried down into the steel. If you let them just sit there and spin in the hole, they get hot, they lose their temper, they're dull. You got to start over. Well, I got a little more to go. See you next time.